Even the smallest measure of gratitude, where they start feeling appreciation, thankfulness. Gratitude, it's emotional signature. When you get something, mm-hmm. When you're receiving something, when something has happened to you, or when something is happening to you, you say thank you because you're receiving something. So the emotional signature of gratitude means the event has already happened or it's happening to you. Mm-hmm. So the moment you open your heart and you feel gratitude, well, that emotion then is telling the body that the experience has already occurred. And the thought then mm-hmm. can make it into the body because it's consistent with the thought. So now you're beginning to program the autonomic nervous system into a very specific destiny. Mm-hmm. You gotta maintain that modified state of mind and body your entire day, mm-hmm. independent of the conditions in your outer environment. Mm-hmm. Independent of your body's cravings of those emotions and habituations mm. and independent from time. Mm. And if you can, get ready because something weird or unusual, some synchronicity, some coincidence, some mm. opportunity is gonna land in your lap and you didn't have to go and get it.
Yes.
It came to you. Now you're the vortex of creation. So if you say to me, well, I was feeling gratitude, but then there was traffic or my coworker sent me a nasty email, then I would say, oh my God, you mean you're allowing your environment, your outer environment, to control how you feel and think, mm-hmm. you're back to the unconscious program that you're the victim to your life.
You got it.
But when you start producing those outcomes in your life, you're gonna pay attention to what you did inside of you, and you're gonna believe more that you're the creator of your life and less of the victim of your life. Conscious of those unconscious thoughts, they would never slip by your mind unchecked by you. Now, that is when you really catch yourself, right? Yeah. And the research shows that you can get better at this. You could actually sense the thought before it comes. So then you start firing and wiring new thoughts. You start thinking to yourself, who am I gonna be when I open my eyes? Mm. Well, how am I gonna make a difference in the world today? Mm. Who am I gonna be? Mm. How am I gonna love? How am I gonna give? How am I gonna serve? How am I gonna contribute? What things do I wanna really do today? Mm. And in the act of closing your eyes and just thinking about and rehearsing what you're gonna do, yes. your brain doesn't know the difference.
Yes.
And if you get caught up in it, you begin to install the neurological hardware in your brain to look like you've already done it. Now the brain's no longer a record of the past.
Yeah.
Now it's a map to the future. You are priming your brain, and if you keep doing it,
yes.
the hardware will become a software program. You know what that means? Mm. You just might start acting like a happy person. Mm. Well, there's no surprise there.
Mm.
You installed the circuits. You can believe in a future that you can't see or experience with your senses yet, but you've thought about enough times in your mind that it's actually, there's physical evidence in your brain to look like it's already happened.
Man.
And you can begin to understand, you can select a new potential in the quantum field and every day emotionally embrace that future reality to such a degree that your body begins to believe it's living in that future reality in the present moment, and you're signaling new genes and new ways to change your body to look like it's already happened. Now think about this. If there's physical evidence by thought alone in your brain and body to look like your wealth or your future has already happened, it's already happened.
It's already happened.
And you're already it. So it's not about your wealth. It's not about your health. It's not about your freedom. It's who you become. So then as you overcome, you become someone else. And so most people don't understand that that the truth is that every time you overcome yourself a little bit more, the side effect is that you love yourself a little bit more. We're changing our brain and body to live in that future present reality so that you feel connected to a future instead of the past. And when you're connected to the past, you're looking for it. And if you're looking for it, you're separate from it. If you're being it, then there's a complete change in energy, and nobody changes until they change their energy. And when you change your energy, you change your life.